Hello boys, welcome back to another session of video tutorials. And this session is meant for class 12th biology students, and this is meant for 13th October 2020. We are into the revision mode and we are revising chapter number 6, molecular basis of inheritance. And yesterday we were talking about the structure and properties of DNA as well as RNA, and the differences between DNA and RNA. We were also talking about the euchromatin and heterochromatin and structure of nucleosome. So going ahead, today in this session we are going to talk about the search for genetic material. What is the genetic material? It is the DNA. So there has been search for genetic material. And many scientists did wonderful experiments to find out the genetic material. So, in this, the first experiment that was performed was transforming principle experiment, and thanks to Frederick Griffith. So, he conducted an experiment in 1928 on bacteria Streptococcus pneumoniae. So, he has conducted an experiment on bacterium called Streptococcus pneumoniae, the one that causes pneumonia. And pneumonia, of course, you know, it's a lung disorder, lung disease. There are two types of strains of this bacteria. Some produce smooth, shiny colonies, smooth, shiny, that's why S strain. And others produce rough colonies, that's why R for rough colonies. So mice infected with S strain, that's virulent, die from pneumonia infection, but mice infected with R strain do not develop pneumonia. So with the knowledge of this at the background, what is that Frederick Griffith has done? So he has injected S strain bacteria, Streptococcus pneumoniae, injected into the mice, okay, rat, small rat, and rats died. And next he injected R strain into the mice, but surprisingly mice is alive. And now more interesting one is S strain, he has heat killed and injected to mice, and the mice was lucky, they were alive. Look at this. I want you to differentiate between step number 1 and step number 3. Both are S strain. Here it is live. Here it is heat killed. And here when it is live, it killed the mice. When it is heat killed, mice was alive. Keep that in the mind. And now S strain, more interesting. S strain, which is heat killed, he mixed it with R strain, which is not dangerous. Injected into the mice, and look at that, mice died. So that means there was something that is transferred from S strain to R strain. Normally in Kannada we say Savas dosha, okay? Same thing happened here. It's because of the circle friendship. So Griffith concluded that R strain bacteria have somehow transformed by heat killed S strain, Savas dosha, heat killed S strain bacteria. Some transforming principles transferred from S strain to R strain and enabled the R strain to synthesize a smooth polysaccharide coat and become virulent. This must be due to the transfer of genetic material. But still, Griffith did not say what is that genetic material. Something is transformed. That's why we say transforming principle. And taking the clue from Griffith's experiment, three more scientists continued the experiment: Oswald Avery, Colin McLeod, and McLon McCarthy worked out to determine the biochemical nature of transforming principle of Griffith. What is the chemistry part of it? They purified biochemicals, proteins, DNA, RNA, from the heat-killed S cells to see which ones could transform live R cells into S cells. They discovered that DNA alone from S bacteria caused R bacteria to become transformed. So it is the DNA. How is that they have done? Remember the video that I had sent to you? He has used, all the three scientists use the corresponding enzyme which digests, like proteins get digested by proteases, RNA get digested by RNAs, and DNA by DNAs. And when they found that it is the DNA which was left that transformed the S bacteria and R bacteria. So S bacteria caused R bacteria to become transformed. So they concluded that DNA is the genetic material. In the absence of proteins and RNA, the left out choice was DNA. So still, to prove further, two more scientists, they did a wonderful experiment, Alfred Hershey and Martha Chase. So we say it is famous as Hershey and Chase experiment. And they proved a wonderful concept, experimental proof that DNA is the only genetic material. So what is that they have done? They worked with virus that infected bacteria called bacteriophage. All of you know, bacteriophage is a virus. Remember, bacteriophage is a virus that kills bacteria. So don't think that bacteriophage is a bacteria, okay? In one preparation, the protein part was made radioactive and in the other, nucleic acid was made radioactive. So here, DNA, just now in our last session, we talked that it is made up of three molecules. One is the deoxyribose sugar molecule, a pentose sugar, we said. Second, phosphate, phosphoric acid, and third, nitrogenous bases. On the other hand, proteins, of course, the part of the protein is sulfur. So they have taken sulfur, radioactive substance of the sulfur, and radioactive isotope of the phosphorus. So these two phase preparations were allowed to infect the culture of E. coli. Soon after infection, before lysis, means death of cells, the E. coli cells were gently agitated in a blender, just like a mixie, okay, to loosen the adhering phase particles, and the culture was centrifuged. The heavier infected material cells pelleted to the bottom as usual, and the lighter viral particles were present as the supernatant. It was found that when bacteriophage containing radioactive DNA was used to infect E. coli, the pellet contained radioactivity. See, that means DNA is the genetic material. If bacteriophage containing radioactive protein coat was used to infect E. coli, the supernatant contained most of the radioactivity. His experiment shows that protein does not enter the bacterial cell and only DNA is the genetic material. That is the great experiment done by Hershey and Chase. So this is what they have done. So in this is the bacteriophage, of course, all of you know. And here, radioactive phosphate, see, labeled DNA. Here, I'm just making it bigger, okay. And then, in this case, sulfur is the protein part. So they have used radioactivity of sulfur. So when they got infected, those in the first stage, it's the infection stage, as you are seeing here, the bacteriophage started infecting the bacteria. And then blending was done, and then with the help of a machine, centrifugal machine, the centrifugation is done, and then you can see here radioactive phosphorus P32 detected in cells. No radioactivity detected in supernatant. So that is the concluding story. And the other side, to ascertain that DNA is the only genetic material, no radioactive sulfur is detected in the cells, and radioactive sulfur detected in supernatant. That means that gives a concluding evidence that protein did not take part in the process. It is only the DNA having phosphate group has taken part. Hence, DNA is the only genetic material. So, properties of genetic material. It should be able to generate its replica. So, replication of DNA should take place. It should chemically and structurally be stable. It should provide the scope for slow changes like mutations that are required for evolution. It should be able to express itself in the form of Mendelian characters. So DNA is chemically less reactive but structurally more stable as compared to RNA. So DNA is better genetic material. RNA is used as genetic material as well as catalyst and more reactive, so less stable. Therefore, DNA has evolved from RNA. Replication of DNA. Thanks to Professor Watson and Professor Crick, they suggested two strands of DNA separate from each other and act as template for synthesis of new complementary strands. After the completion of replication, each DNA molecule would have one parental and one newly synthesized strand. This method is called semi-conservative replication, like double helix DNA. So you got two parental strands, P1, P2, I will write. So parental strand P1 and P2. So once a little bit of energy is supplied, because in between hydrogen bonds, weak hydrogen bonds are there, the two strands vertically split. So you got P1 and P2. DNA is completely replicated or separated. So based on this parental strand 1, a new strand will be synthesized. This is new, and so as this new synthesis, new strand. So the new strands will be complementary to parental strands. Hence, it is semi-conservative replication. Why semi-conservative? Out of the two now DNA molecules that are formed, so this is DNA 1, DNA 2. Half of the DNA is from the original parents. So 50% is contributed from the parents, original parents. Hence we say semi-conservative replication. Meselson and Stahl shows experimental evidence of semi-conservative replication by growing E. coli on nutrient media containing nitrogen salts, that is NH4Cl, ammonium chloride, and nitrogen he has taken as 15. Labeled with radioactive 15N, and 15N was incorporated into both the strands of DNA. Why 15N? Because nitrogen bases are there now. Nitrogen bases contain nitrogen, so wherever nitrogen is there, instead of N14, N15 is incorporated. So once N15 is incorporated, it's a heavy dose of nitrogen, so it is a heavy isotope. 15N was incorporated into both the strands of DNA, and such a DNA was heavier than the DNA obtained from E. coli grown on medium containing normal nitrogen, that is N14. Then they transferred the E. coli cells onto a medium containing normal nitrogen. After one generation, when bacterial cell has multiplied into two, they isolated the DNA and evaluated its density. Its density was intermediate between that of the heavier 15N DNA and lighter 14N DNA, because one part is 15, one part is 14N. This is because during replication, new DNA molecule with one 15N old strand and a complementary 14N new strand was formed, as we explained. So that's why semi-conservation replication of DNA is proved beyond doubts. So its density is intermediate between the two. So replication of DNA require enzyme DNA polymerase that catalyze the polymerization in one strand, that is 5' to 3' only, after unwinding with the help of helicase enzyme. So replication in one strand is continuous, other strand it is discontinuous to synthesize Wakajaki fragments. Again, a scientist by name Wakajaki has found out this, hence the name Wakajaki fragments, that are joined together by enzyme DNA ligase. Ligase means one that joins. Differences between leading and lagging strands of DNA replication. So fragments, it is formed continuously as single fragment, leading strand, lagging strand, it is In the beginning, it is formed in the form of small fragments called Okazaki fragments. So a leading strand will be continuous like this, and the lagging strand will be having pieces. These are Okazaki fragments. And RNA primer, it requires only one primer to initiate the growth. Every fragment requires a separate RNA primer to initiate. So this requires RNA primer, this requires. So multiple RNA primers are required. DNA ligase to join, not required because it is a continuous line. It's a thread, a continuous thread. Required to join DNA fragments. See, all these are to be joined and formed. So for this, DNA ligase is a must. Direction, always 5 prime to 3 prime. Of complete strand, it is 3 prime to 5 prime. However, for Okazaki fragments, it is 5 prime to 3 prime. So these are the various requirements for that. And then, this is how Okazaki fragments are shown. So this is a parental DNA double strand. So helicases and the top isomerases will be there. You've got a daughter DNA double strand, 5 prime to 3 prime, and then RNA primer is there. This is RNA primer, and that continuously it is there, so it is a leading strand. Whereas here you can see the fragments. So fragment 1, fragment 2, fragment 2, fragments are there. So we call it as Okazaki fragments. So this is a lagging strand. Why? Continuity is lagging, that's why lagging strand. And then once the replication fork is formed, now daughter DNA double strand, RNA primer will be used, whereas in the new strand it is 3 prime to 5 prime, and old strand it is 5 prime to 3 prime. So it is done. And in our next class we will talk about an important step concept called transcription. Until then, keep practicing, post your doubts in our